this mud banks was exposed at the beginning of the month when we had a strong gale force southeasterly wind blowing through. But that wind has long subsided. For the last 2 days we've had moderately strong northeasterly winds blowing, and the mud banks are still not covered. The distance you can see the flamingos waiting on the mud. At least they've got some place to feed. I don't care who you are and what qualifications you are, but if you try and convince the public that this mud is a natural phenomenon, then you are selling bullshit to us. This mud has been pushing. I'm just going to break my story quickly with this hippo up the duct. Okay, back to the story. This mud has been deposited here by the Umfolozi River. The current management plan that has been delayed now for 3 years is to bring the Umfolozi River and the St. Lucia River as one river, as one system. Yeah, that is going to repair the function of the estuary, remains to be seen. In 1958, the estuary and the lake, the estuary and the Umfolozi River was started to be managed as a separate estuary and the lake system. Yes, the Umfolozi floodplain farmers has got a lot to do with the floodplains of the Umfolozi River not working and filtering the mud out. But this mud originates as far up as Freight. This is not only an issue for Isimangaliso to resolve, but they manage it as if it's their only issue. This is an environmental issue that originates in Freight in the catchment areas of the Umfolozi River. If you go further north into the lake system, there's four other rivers that feed mud into the system. The only one that has got some sort of a filtering system is the Lui River. But the Lui River is not flowing now for a couple of years. It's been dry. One of the concerns I kept on raising was the oyster banks. Since 1993, it was one of my main concerns. Since 1993, on all the meetings, I've been told that oysters don't grow in estuaries. Now, if you look carefully at that man-made island there, you'll see that it's riddled with oysters. When you go and Google oysters, you'll see that the final cycle of their life before they reproduce into a new cycle is in the estuary. If we look at oysters, St. Lucia estuary is the most important life-giving body of ecology for 350 kilometers north and south. That reaches from Maputo in the north all the way to Durban in the south. This should be a functioning, pristine estuary as it was in 1999 on the 15th of December. As per the marine scientist appointed by St. Lucia, or rather Isimangaliso Wetland Park Authority, that was funded with the GIF fund, $9 million. They have found in 2012 that this estuary was a class E estuary, which is virtually mud. In 2012, the Wetland Park Authority, Isimangaliso Wetland Park Authority, the managers of this pristine wild heritage, knew that this estuary is dead. Yet 3 years later, their postponement tactics of tender procedures is not helping the estuary.